Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? Lord, why should my heart, feel lonely and long? Heaven home, yeah. He watches over me.
Good evening to all of you, and welcome to this celebration of life for our beloved Lawrence Leo Lyons. I'm Reverend Marjorie Matthews, and I serve as the pastor of Plymouth Church, also known as the Jazz and Justice Church. We were blessed to be Lawrence's home church here in the Bay Area, but we are just one of the many beloved communities to which Lawrence belonged. We are thankful to co-host this evening's gathering with our friends from the Oakland LGBTQ Center. And I want to give a shout out to Joe Hawkins, the co-founder and CEO of the center. And to everyone from the center who's with us this evening, welcome to all of you. If you're here from the center, will you wave your hand? I know that we also have friends with us from the Queer Healing Arts Center and the Open Mic. If you are part of that community, will you wave your hand? And I think we might even have some friends with us from our sister church, City of Refuge United Church of Christ. Will you wave your hand if you are here from City of Refuge? And of course, we have with us several of Lawrence's family members this evening. I believe that his sister, Ashley, his cousin, Jasmine, and I don't know if his mom, Arvanola, but maybe his mom is also with us. And are there other family members here? If you are part of Lawrence's family, will you just wave your hand? I want to extend a special welcome to all of you, along with my deepest condolences and heartfelt prayers. I want to acknowledge that all of us are feeling such heartache this evening. Lawrence is gone from us way too soon. And our sorrow is so profound. And yet, we have called this evening's gathering a celebration of life, because even in the midst of all our sorrow, we are so thankful for his life. We are so thankful that God made him. We are so thankful that we were blessed to know him, all of us who are gathered here this evening. And so I know that tears will flow this evening. I have my box of tissues right here, everyone. But I hope that our laughter will flow as well. And so in the spirit of sorrow and celebration, we're going to go to God in prayer. And I invite you to take a moment to just settle in. Close your eyes if you want to do that, or bow your head, or take a moment to just focus on your breathing if that will bless you. So let us settle into this time. And now let us pray. Holy God, we have gathered this evening to give thanks for the life of our beloved Lawrence Leo Lyons. We thank you, God, for making him. We thank you, God, for blessing us to know him. We thank you, God, for his genius and his justice-making spirit, for his beautiful mind and his beautiful heart. We thank you, God, for his artistic spirit, for the music and the poetry that flowed out of him and lifted and inspired all of us. We thank you, God, for his fierceness, for his truth-telling, for his courage to claim all of who he was, to live free and full-hearted in this world. We ask, O God, that you draw close to us this evening, that you comfort our grieving hearts, that you grant us whatever measure of peace and strength of spirit we need to carry forward the legacy Lawrence has left us. Remind us that although he is gone from his body, he is present in our hearts always, and he is present, God, with you and all the saints and ancestors who live on in the life beyond this life. We thank you, Holy God, and we lift this prayer in all your blessed names. And we say together, Amen and Ashe.
Thank you. Our first scripture reading is the 23rd Psalm. Hear now these words. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, O God. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of God forever.
Our second scripture reading is from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3. Hear now these words. To everything there is a season and a time for every matter under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. To everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. Here ends the reading.
Good evening, everyone. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he's waiting and watching for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, beloved, come home. Lawrence was a child of the church, so the songs and the scriptures of the church were deep inside his heart and often emerged in his powerful poetry. He also had a deep love for classical music. I wish I'd known that. And he especially loved the German Requiem by Brahms. At an open mic performance some time ago, he sang part of the Requiem by Brahms, and he sang it and German, yes, German. After which he read a poem he had written that builds off the words from the Requiem, words from scripture, and words from gospel songs. So, let us hear now this beautiful poem from our beloved Lawrence Leo Lyons, a poem that feels so right for this moment. You now have sorrow, but I shall see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy no one shall take from you. Weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Evil rises from the shadows, but the saints, draped in the color of earth, told me, baby, there's a leak in this old building, and my soul has got to move to a building, spirit made by hand.
They had an exit strategy from oppression, those saints. They used to say, this joy I have, the world didn't give to me, and the world can't take it away. They had a radical self-care regimen to be black and have joy, radical mourning joy, that is. My lessons come from the saints of old, those who walk with us in the spirit and illuminate our way. I'm going to press on toward the mark of the high calling, which is justice and equity. We are sorrowful now, but hope rises from the ashes like the phoenix.
You know what? Lawrence, who I call Lolo, was an unofficial official member of the Plymouth Church Choir. That means whenever he came on to into our church, he had to sing with us. And I'm the choir director, so what I say goes. But the one thing that I love so much about him is his savoir-faire. He was an amazing, and still is, an amazing, amazing being at our church. And you know,
the poem that was just read, mm-hmm. I might be mistaken, but I heard joy mentioned at least four times, and especially the words, "This joy I have," which we're about to bring up the spirit a little, so we would love for you to tap your toes, stomp your feet, and clap your hands and sing along.
Yeah, this is the rhythm, right?
Come on now.
Lawrence would not appreciate it
if
he saw you just sitting there.
Sorry.
One, two, mm-hmm. one, two,
three. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me.
No, no, no.
This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away.
Let's do love, everybody.
This love that I have, the world didn't give it to me. No, no, no. This love that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This love that I have, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. Come on, Gail, say.
Peace, peace.
This peace that I have, the world didn't give it to me.
No, no, no.
This peace that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This peace that I have, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away.
What'd they do?
The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away.
Amen.
All right.
Lawrence did embody love that the world couldn't give. Such, I think we can all, having met Lawrence even just once, know how magnanimous their heart was, and such a bright light. I'm Rachel, I'm the former associate pastor of Plymouth and a person who loved Lawrence, as I know so many of you are. And so my heart is with all of you today. Lawrence's sister Ashley has shared some words in remembrance of her brother and wanted someone else to read them. And so I'm honored to share her words with you on her behalf. She says, "My brother Lawrence was one of my best friends. We argued, annoyed each other, sometimes made each other extremely mad, but we never doubted the love we had for each other. And yes, I feel a bit lonely now because we were supposed to grow old together, but I also know he will always be with me. I feel blessed to be among you this evening and to know that you too were able to know his big smile, big personality, and big heart. Thank you for all the love and support." And those are the ends of her words. Ashley, please know that all of us here tonight and so many people in other spaces and communities are surrounding you with love, holding endless stories to share of hilarity and conversation and deep love from and for Lawrence. Would you all join me in prayer? Holy One, we lift up Ashley and Lawrence's mother, Arvanola, and Lawrence's entire family. May they feel Lawrence's presence with them, gone from the body, but near in spirit. May they be touched with sweet memories and surprising moments. And may you carry them through their grief, surrounded by tenderness, God. And Holy One, we pray for all of Lawrence's family, blood family and chosen family, for each dear friend and community member. Lawrence created family wherever they went. And so we pray for every acquaintance who was fortunate enough to cross paths with Leo's magnetic and brilliant energy. We know ourselves to be the lucky few, God, blessed to know and to love such a brilliant, beautiful, hilarious, talented, loving soul. Thank you, Lawrence, for the magic you carried, the dreams you dared to dream with us. May you be at peace over the rainbow now, where the clouds are far behind you. Amen.
My name is Vanessa, and this is Ren. We were friends with Lawrence in college and continued on to this day in the Bay. This is a letter to Lawrence, to Leo, on behalf of their church family and all of their chosen family. Dear Lawrence, beloved Leo, we all expected to see you again when this pandemic shutdown ended. We all expected to see you again dressed in your signature outfit of jeans, dashiki, and poncho. We all expected to hear you again the way your laughter, that wonderful laughter, would arrive even before you walked into the room. We all expected to hear you again, to hear your voice, that beautiful voice, your song full of church and blues and Brahms. We all expected to see your dreams and plans come true. Dreams for yourself, for your BIPOC friends, and for the world to become a more justice-filled place.
How could we have known how soon you'd leave us? You were family. We walked with each other through tumult and transition. We helped sort through the pieces. How are we to walk through the rest without you? You were larger than life, so life wasn't gentle with you, but you wrestled back and squeeze out all the goodness from it. How we miss you. We are gathering up the gifts you left behind. The songs, the poems, and political diatribes, and photos and videos, and memories and moments. We are gathering up your dreams and tucking them in our hearts, inviting you to live in us, in all of us, in every poem we write, in every song we sing, in every truth we tell. Travel on, fierce, sweet soul. Thank you for blessing our lives with love from all your people.
Thank you, Vanessa and Ren. You know, usually at a service like this one, somebody preaches a eulogy, preaches a sermon or a message. But we're not doing that this evening. And usually at a service like this one, people come forward to share a tribute or a story or a remembrance, but we're not doing that either. We're gonna do something a little bit different. In the piece, the beautiful piece they just shared with us, Vanessa and Ren said to Lawrence, "We are gathering up your dreams and tucking them in our hearts, inviting you to live on in us." And so I invite you to join us now in a little ritual of remembrance. I invite you to think about some way that you want Lawrence, Leo, to live on in you. Just one aspect of their spirit that you're going to intentionally nurture in yourself and carry forward in their name. Not just something you liked or admired about Lawrence, about Leo, but something you're committed to carrying forward for them. So here's the deal. These are not sermons. We said we're not doing that. These are not speeches. These are not proclamations. It's just one sentence that you get to say, one sentence. I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's or Leo's, and then you fill in the blank. We want as many people as possible to have a chance to share. This is how we're weaving together the eulogy, all of us together. So when you're ready to share, just unmute your audio, say your one sentence, and then mute your audio again. And I think that, let's see, Shell, Stephen, are you gonna start us off? Who's gonna start us off?
Yeah. I will. There's so many things. Okay. I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's ability to, and myself, to uplift people when I enter a room, to make one feel good about themselves.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's very clear call to Christian ministry.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's love for music and people.
Nice. We're going to carry forth his memory as a family by dedicating the prayer bench that we've created at the church to his memory.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's outspokenness about the things that he believed in.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's true radical love and acceptance for everybody on this earth.
And I'm going to carry forward how Lawrence was able to ask for what he wanted.
And I'm going to carry forward some of the fearlessness that Lawrence has provided. I'm inspired by.
I want to carry forth Lawrence's unbridled sense of freedom.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's fierce protection and love of Black women and girls.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's true nature of what it means to be a Leo.
I'm going to carry forth Lawrence's absolute acceptance and expression of who he is, who they were.
Let's take a few more.
I'll carry forward Leo's proudness of being Black and beautiful.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's willingness to call bullshit when he saw it.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's kindness and appreciation for others.
I want to carry forth his love for all mankind and his dedication to making the world a better place to live.
I will carry forward their love of dance, poetry, and song. And also with that, like how I often tell all the stories I've known of Leo and other Leos I've known in the same sentence.
I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's, my cousin's, sense of family and love that he gave to all of us every day. And thank you everyone so much for being here, because this is really touching me tonight. So thank you so much.
We love him very much.
Yes, bless you, bless you. We want to take one more spoken tribute, and then I want to read what is in the chat. So dear ones, these are some of the things that our gathered community has shared in the chat this evening. I'm going to carry forward their beauty and presence. I'll miss singing and jovial laugh and the religious political banter I was his neighbor and will never forget our daily talks or the words of wisdom to my children. I will miss their singing and poetry. I will definitely carry on their love of dance, poetry, and song. I'm going to carry forward Leo's commitment to social justice. I will carry Leo's fierceness and their commitment to caring for others with me. I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's confidence. I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's warmth when greeting even a stranger. I'm going to carry forward Lawrence's bravery in beloved community spaces. I'm going to carry forward Leo's commitment to fostering community. I will carry forward their fierce protection of Black women. I will carry forward their beautiful, bright energy and love for the church. Confidence and honesty, someone says. Oh my, it goes on, you all. I can't keep up with all of it. I hope you will read it in the chat for yourselves. But more than that, I hope that we will carry in our hearts all of what has been shared, and that we will keep these commitments to carry forward in Lawrence's spirit. And so holding in our hearts now all that has been shared, it overflows, right? Our hearts can barely even hold it all, but holding it in our hearts, all our intentions for Lawrence and how Lawrence will live on in us, we are going to lift one last prayer for him now. It is called the prayer of commendation, when we commend their spirit to God. If we were all together in the sanctuary at Plymouth Church, we would rise at this point and we would form a big circle. We would probably join hands. We'd probably have a large photo of Lawrence on the altar, and someone would go up and get that photo and hold it up as we lift this prayer. So we have to close our eyes and imagine that we're all together just like that in the sanctuary and gathered in a big circle and holding each other's hands. And somebody is holding aloft Lawrence's picture. And so with that image in our minds, let us pray. Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend now your child, Lawrence Lyons. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, a child of your very own heart, beloved by you and by all of us, a bright spirit whose light continues undimmed. Receive Lawrence now into the arms of mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the company of all the ancestors and the saints. We pray this, dear God, in all your holy names, and together we all say amen, and we all say ashe. Dear ones, we have one last song to close the service, and this is Lawrence himself singing. A few years ago, our church held a special service in honor of James Baldwin, and I asked Lawrence to sing His Eye is on the Sparrow. And so the last song this evening belongs to our beloved Lawrence.
Should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadows come? And why should my heart be lonely? Jesus in me, where is my torsion, a torsion, a constant friend. Is he? Is I? Me, I want to sing that again. I said, should I feel? Charles, should I feel discouraged? Oh, and why? Should a shadow?
I will never again be able to hear his eyes on the sparrow without thinking about our Lawrence. Fly free now, dear Lawrence. Godspeed to you and blessings on your continuing journey. We love you so very much. Friends, in just a moment, I'm going to invite all of you to unmute your audio and we're going to do one last little thing. But before we do that, will you please join me in thanking all of our worship leaders this evening and all of our musicians and our wonderful Zoom team? Will you just like give them some love and praise? God bless all of you who helped with this evening's service. So, in just a minute, I'm going to invite everyone to unmute their audio, and then we're going to count to three. And we're all going to shout, "We love you, Lawrence." And it's going to sound crazy and cacophonous because Zoom is not made for a whole lot of people to talk at the same time, but we're going to do it anyway. So unmute your audio, everybody. Everybody unmute it. Okay, I'm going to count to three. When I get to three, we're all going to shout, "We love you, Lawrence." So one, two, three.
We love you, Lawrence.
Y'all, I don't think he heard us. Let's do that again. One, two, three.
We love you, Lawrence.
Love you.
Amen. Amen. Alex and Lawrence. Okay. So Alex and Lawrence have remuted all of us. Dear ones, this concludes this celebration. Thank you so much for joining in this evening gathering. Okay. Okay, I think we've remuted everyone again. So thank you very much for joining in this evening's gathering. Please remember that there will be a funeral service for Lawrence at 10 o'clock tomorrow. The funeral will be in Los Angeles, but you'll be able to view it on Zoom. I believe there will be another celebration after that, maybe at 11:30, sponsored by our friends at the Queer Healing Arts Center, and that will also be on Zoom. And so for now, God bless you all. God bless you. As we do every Sunday at Plymouth Church, we don't like just signing off because that feels too abrupt. So what we do is we count down from five and then we all blow each other kisses and then we end the session. So will you join me in counting down? Five, four, three, two, one. God bless you all. God bless you all. Good night.